An AI algorithm piloting an F-16 Fighting Falcon in a simulated dogfight against a seasoned U.S. Air Force pilot achieved a perfect score with 5 straight wins in a competition. The Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, DARPA, held the final round of its third and final AlphaDogfight competition on Thursday, putting an AI system designed by Heron Systems against a human pilot in a simulated within visual range air combat situation. According to Breaking Defense, Heron's AI went head-to-head with a graduate of the U.S. Air Force's Weapons Instructor course with the callsign Banger. An expert commentator, DARPA's Justin Mock, said that the AI algorithm demonstrated superhuman aiming ability during the dogfight, and the human pilot couldn't score a single hit. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how AI beating a fighter pilot in a virtual dogfight shows that the U.S. military is stealing a march in this important area. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. AI is being seen as the next big thing when it comes to warfare. The US and its near-peer rivals like Russia and China are investing considerable resources in AI to take an advantage. The fact is that the first state to develop AI would have serious advantages over others militarily. Artificial intelligence models are improving every day and have shown their value in many applications. Initially, these systems could be useful for tasks such as identifying a target from satellite image, but in the future, AI could act autonomously and be used for offensive action. Russian President Vladimir Putin was quoted last year saying, "Artificial intelligence is the future, not only of Russia, but of all of mankind. Whoever becomes the leader in this sphere will become the ruler of the world." AI has stamped its authority in several experiments. Garry Kasparov, who's perhaps the greatest chess player in history, lost to IBM's supercomputer called Deep Blue in 1997. The loss sent shockwaves across the world and seemed to herald a new era of machine mastery over man. Last year, DARPA explained that while AI can beat human beings in games like chess, there's no AI currently in existence that can outduel a human strapped into a fighter jet in a high-speed, high-G dogfight. DARPA spent the last year trying to resolve this through an aerial warfare contest called the AlphaDogfight Trials, which would simulate man-unmanned combat. The Pentagon's Mad Science Unit created the competition to assess how AI could assist pilots and attract developers to its Air Combat Evolution (ACE) program. Once the algorithms have shown they work in simulations, the ACE program will progress to small-scale unmanned aerial vehicles, and then graduate to live operational aircraft. In the first round, AIs were pitted against each other. 8 teams participated in it, and an algorithm developed by Heron Systems won it. Reports stated that the Maryland-based company guided its jet with deep reinforcement learning, which helps AI improve its decisions by testing out different approaches and learning from its mistakes. After the first round win, Heron faced its final challenge, a best-of-5 aerial duel against an Air Force F-16 pilot known as Banger. All of the simulated fighter battles were restricted to allow the use of the nose cannon only, and human pilot entered the competition wearing a VR helmet. Heron quickly built up a 4-0 lead. Gunned down 4 times, but somehow still alive, Banger had no choice but to change up his game plan. He said, "The standard things that we do as fighter pilots are not working, so for this last one, I'll try to change it up a little bit just to see if we can do something different. That initial turn is where I lose a lot of life. I just gotta look for opportunities to minimize the distance separation away from the adversary to try to get him back in so I press inside or stay outside his nose area." Banger pulled up to 9 Gs, 9 times the force of gravity, and hit speeds over 500 miles per hour, or 805 kilometers per hour. He then dropped the jet down to 13,000 feet, trying to drag Heron close to the ground. The plan seemed to be working. Heron couldn't get its gun low enough to shoot. But within a few seconds, the AI was back on Banger's tail and was able to execute the final hit. Link of the video of the dogfight is given in the description section below. Ben Bell, Heron's senior machine learning engineer, told Sandbox News that the simulated environment put the AI combatant at an advantage over its human foe. But it's to be noted that the virtual environment also allowed the human pilot to execute high-G command maneuvers that might not be possible for a human pilot in the real world. Still, the achievement is significant for an AI system whose development reportedly started just a year ago. As per Defense One, Bell said that Heron's AI program learned fast, gaining roughly 12 years of experience over the course of 4 billion simulations. After their AI won the competition, the Heron Systems developers gave a Q&A via YouTube, explaining some of the behavior they saw and even some movements that were unexpected. According to Heron, their agent is capable of running, without real-time image recognition, on something as small as an NVIDIA Tegra chip. The ACE program, according to DARPA, is designed to deliver a capability that enables a pilot to attend to a broader, more global air command mission while their aircraft and teamed unmanned systems are engaged in individual tactics. Commenting on the ambitious goals of DARPA's ACE program, Colonel Dan Javersek, the program manager in DARPA's Strategic Technology Office, said last year that the agency envisions a future in which AI handles the split-second maneuvering during within-visual range dogfights, keeping pilots safer and more effective as they orchestrate large numbers of unmanned systems into a web of overwhelming combat effects. Given the Department of Defense's growing interest in AI, DARPA is not the only one pursuing these types of opportunities. Speaking at a Mitchell Institute event in early June, Air Force Lieutenant General Jack Shanahan, then the head of the Joint Artificial Intelligence Center, said that the Air Force is looking at putting an AI-driven autonomous drone up against a manned fighter aircraft in a dogfight next year. In December 2016, 123 member nations of the UN's Review Conference of the Convention on Conventional Weapons unanimously agreed to begin formal discussions on autonomous weapons. Of these, 19 have already called for an outright ban. Viewers may note that in 2017, an open letter signed by 116 founders of robotics and artificial intelligence companies from 26 countries urged the United Nations to urgently address the challenge of lethal autonomous weapons and ban their use internationally. Self-directing AI weapons constitute the third weaponry revolution, after gunpowder and the atomic bomb. Although real-life Terminators are far from reality, things could eventually come to this. It's clear that major military powers like the US, Russia, and China are not willing to let go of trying to gain an AI edge. There were some reports that China is actually ahead of the US in this field, but the latest demonstration by this DARPA initiative shows that America is probably the frontrunner. It remains to be seen how things pan out in the future.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.